Hi guys, the purpose of this video is for people having this Fortnite crash reporter error when running DirectX 12. I'm just gonna let you guys know that this error here is not software related. Just to let you guys know, this is hardware related, guys. I did some tests on this Fortnite crash reporter. A lot of people are making videos online about how to fix it, such as this person and a bunch of others. And whatever these guys are saying is absolutely incorrect. It's not gonna fix the issue. The point is you guys wanna fix the problem. And the problem is not gonna be fixed with software. This is not software related, guys. This DirectX 12 problem that people are having is not software related. It's hardware related, okay? I'm gonna give you a few examples. My son's running an i9-11900K. He's running Corsair RAM 3200 megahertz with XMP. He has absolutely no issues running DirectX 12 in Fortnite. He does not even get this crash report error. He's got 128 gigs of RAM on his computer, all four slots filled, and he doesn't have this issue. Reason being is the i9-11900K. The recommended megahertz for that machine is 3200. Okay, a lot of people have the wrong memory and the wrong bandwidth in their machine as to why they have this issue. Okay, just because you have higher megahertz in your RAM does not mean that your machine is going to run reliably. Okay, I was just going to give you an example. My machine is a 13900K with 128 gig of RAM. Okay, I so have 3600 megahertz DDR4. Four slots filled at 128 RAM. Well, guess what, guys? 3600 megahertz RAM is too high for a 1300K. 3200 is a recommended for a 1300K in DDR4. If you're running DDR5 on a 1300K machine, 5600 is the max if you want to run reliably with XMP. Anything higher than 5600 megahertz of RAM is going to be unstable and you'll have crashes. Okay, so that's the reason why a lot of people are crashing and getting this error, because it's memory related. This is not software related, just so you guys know. Another thing to keep in mind is that the DirectX 12, right now, if you're running Windows 10 or 11 with the newest updates, right now it's called DirectX 12 Ultimate. Okay, so that is the newest DirectX 12 that we currently have on our machines. You can't disable this. You can't make it go back to the old DirectX 12 or 11. It is what it is. This is what it's going to stay at, unfortunately. So I'm just letting you guys know that this error is not related to software. So what I would do, guys, is number one, figure out what type of machine you have. You need to check the memory that you have, the megahertz, and the XMP. So what I would do is, before you guys start fooling around with your software, I would take off the XMP, okay, from your machine, disable it, use DirectX 12 in Fortnite, and see if it still crashes with XMP off. If the XMP is off and it's not crashing, it means it's your memory. It means it doesn't like the memory that you have in your machine. Maybe the megahertz of your RAM is too high for the machine that you're running. Okay, because I've tried once in the past 3600 megahertz RAM on an i9 11 generation and it was causing issues. Okay, an i9 11 generation is designed for 3200 megahertz RAM. It even tells you right here. Basically, i9 1100K. Basically, they're stating that the best memory speed for this computer is 3200 megahertz. Okay? Yeah, you could go higher on the megahertz with different RAM, but then you may have problems with DirectX 12, like many people are having. So just so you guys know, what you guys need to do when you're troubleshooting this DirectX 12 error, number one, remove XMP. Number two, how many memory sticks are in your machine? Do you have one? Do you have two? Do you have all four filled? Okay, so what you guys need to do is, if you guys have, let's just say 64 RAM gigs, that be two slots filled. See how that goes, and make sure that the megahertz of your RAM is not too high for the machine that you have. Okay, because that makes a difference. Okay, so first things first, try it with no XMP, see if it crashes. If it doesn't crash without the XMP, then you know that with the XMP on, that the megahertz of your RAM is too high for the CPU that you're running. And certain CPUs don't like memory that's too high in megahertz. So that's what's causing the XMP to make the DirectX 12 crash. Okay, so that's the conclusion I've come to. I've done many tests. My son's, like I said, he's got an 1100K i9 with 3200 megahertz RAM, and he's never experienced this error ever. Okay, but he is running the right RAM for the right machine, and he's never experienced this. I'm running right now on my 1300K, 128 RAM, and I have not experienced this, but I could tell you when I tried clocking my RAM higher in megahertz, I got this error in Fortnite, just so you guys know. So basically, you guys have to make sure that you're matching up the RAM according to your CPU. Don't use too high of a RAM in megahertz if your machine is requesting a certain megahertz. Okay, yes, I could put higher megahertz on this machine, but it's not going to make it faster. Okay, if anything, you're going to get this error. Okay, so that's what I would do, guys. Try removing the XMP. If you have all four sticks in the machine, try two sticks instead of four. Try the XMP on with two sticks, see if it crashes. If it doesn't crash, it means that your machine doesn't like four sticks of RAM with XMP. That could be a possibility. Also, make sure that the RAM speed isn't too high for the CPU that you're running. So double check that as well. A lot of people think just because you have 3600 megahertz RAM versus 32, it's better. Not necessarily. A 3600 megahertz of RAM may freeze on an i9-1100K, which is a 3200 won't. 3600 was geared more for Ryzen because a lot of people like to overclock. So you guys have to be careful what kind of RAM you're using in the machine. So this error here is not software related. A lot of people are doing YouTube videos that you got to delete the cache in Epic. You got to delete all these log files. That's not how you're going to fix this problem. Okay. So anyways, guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video and have a good day.